Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for F.Connect. I'm Heather Pioran, Structural Engineer at WSP USA. Today I'll be going through the OpenBridge Modeler Training Volume 1, Introduction to Model-Centric Design. In this series of videos, we'll take you step-by-step through each exercise from the guide. In this session, we'll go through Chapter 3, Exercise 3.1. Specific topics include background information and helpful nomenclature, and going through exercise 3.1, which includes creating a work set and going through the folder structure and location, as well as the OBM backstage. We'll also create a new design file using the f.create file tool. We are also going to download the dataset so that you can have a starting point for the remaining exercises in the guide. Let's begin. Before we get started on exercise 3.1, we wanted to go through a little bit of background information. For additional information, you can go through Chapter 3 in the training guide for more details about these topics. Something that's important to understand the distinction between in terms of nomenclature is workspace versus workset versus workflow, which can be confusing if you're not familiar with them. The workspace is synonymous with F.Connect, which is the CAD software developed by F.Dot to provide all of the necessary resources, tools, and customization that's required on F.Dot projects, and it must be used for compliance. And it includes template files and the proper feature definitions. The workset is a folder structure and the associated files for a given project, including all of the different disciplines. Usually it's named with the FPID number. The workflow is a drop-down menu within OpenBridge Modeler that sets what the tabs are that are displayed on the ribbon. We'll be focusing on the OpenBridge Modeler and drawing workflows, and we'll point them out as we get into the program. The design file versus sheet file depends on which file group you're creating a file dialog box. We'll discuss this further as we get into the exercise. Generally, we like to have a separate design model and reference that design model into another drawing model or sheet model as needed. That way, multiple people can be working on the different files at the same time. We'll go over that more in the Chapter 6 videos. Just wanted to go through the F.Connect folder real quick, as there's some pretty good resources in there. There are a couple of shortcuts for the F.Connect versions of OBM and OBD if you have it installed, as well as some different resources from the F.CAD office, as well as a couple of custom applications, including ClearCrash and Workspace Doctor, which can be helpful if you're having some issues with the program. Now, let's get started on exercise 3.1. So prior to opening the program itself, we are gonna take a look at where F.Connect stores information on your C drive if you do the standalone installation. There are two main folders where it stores information. One of them is the F.Connect folder. Within this folder, it stores the workspace itself for F.Connect, including configuration files. You shouldn't have to make any modifications or really go into this folder for too much. The other folder is the worksets folder. Within this folder is where all of the project information is stored, including all of the DGNs. So the workspace template is the base folder, which gets copied when you create a new workset within the program. So when we create a new workset, it will essentially duplicate the template that we have, and it'll give you your folder structure that's required for F.projects. So as with most other programs, there are a few different ways to launch the program. One of them is through the F.Connect folder that we discussed earlier. There is a shortcut here on your desktop as well, and you can also add a shortcut to the start menu itself. Now, regardless of which way you launch, whenever you launch a new OBM or an existing OpenBridge Modeler file, you want to make sure that you launch it by going through F.Connect for OBM. Do not double-click on the file itself because you may end up opening it in an incorrect version or an incorrect program, depending on what the defaults that you have your computer set to open DGNs with. For F.dot projects, make sure that you always open the F.dot Connect version of OBM, not the standalone OBM icon that you also see on the desktop. The standalone OBM applications won't have the proper configuration, ribbons, and templates that we need to be compliant with F.dot. Also, do not open files created with ORD or MicroStation with OBM. Always make sure that you attach any roadway or other discipline features as references to your bridge model. Now, if you have OpenBridge Designer installed, your path to launch the program is going to look a little bit different. OpenBridge Designer is essentially the link between OBM and other analysis software that Bentley offers, such as LeapBridge Concrete or Steel or RMBridge. So we are going to use the method to launch directly via F.dot Connect for OpenBridge Modeler. So we'll just double click and open up the program. With OpenBridge Modeler, you can access files that are stored on ProjectWise, on a network drive, or on a local drive. For exercise 3.1, we're going to be working with files on a local drive so we can close out of the ProjectWise login dialog box. This is the backstage of OpenBridge Modeler. On the left here, you would see any recent work sets for projects. Down here, you would see any recent files or DGNs. If you had an existing project that you wanted to access, you can navigate to it using the browse icon. This new file button here, we are not going to use. F.dot has created a custom tool for creating a new DGN called the Create File tool. And this tool can only be accessed from within OBM itself. So new files should not be created using this button. We'll create a new file coming up shortly. Up here at the top, we have the current workspace, which is the correct one, F.dot. And then here, the default template is set because that's the only folder structure that is currently located on our local drive. So for a new project, we're going to create a new workset. For the name of the workset, we are going to use the FPID number, and you can find this information in Exercise 3.1 in the manual. We will use 240835715201. You can give it a description if you'd like. The template that we're going to use is the workset template, and that will create the folder structure. Down here, it's showing the location of the root folder, the design files, and the standard files. As you can see, these are all on our local drive here within the workset FDOT folder. If you were working on a network drive, you would have to set up your environmental variables to access the network drive rather than the local drive. And the same thing with a ProjectWise project. So we'll select OK. And this is now generating our workset based on the workset template. So you should now be able to see our new project here with the proper folder structure set up. Now that we have our new workset, we can navigate to the blank file DGN here through browse. And this blank file DGN will be how we create a new file for use within F.dot Connect for OBM. Now that we are within the blank file DGN, we're going to go ahead and access the Create File tool. As you can see here, we have a warning that says that this file should not be used for F.dot work. Essentially, the whole reason to get into this blank file is just to get you into the F.dot Connect workspace in order to access the Create File tool. So as long as we are within the OpenBridge Modeler workflow up here, in the top left, within the FDOT tab, within the Actions group here, you'll have a Create File tool. So we will create a file using this dialog box here. As you can see, the workset is the work set that we created earlier. There are multiple options for discipline. We're going to use structures. As you can see under the file group here, this is what I was talking about earlier in terms of design file and sheet files. So we're going to use a design file since we are creating a bridge model. Once you select the file group, the file types that are available under a given file group will show up. We are going to create a bridge 3D model. And when you select this file type here of bridge 3D model, it automatically selects the proper output folder and also the correct seed file here, which in our case is the structures 3D seed file. Now here in the output, we are going to refer to this bridge as B1, and we're going to use the modifier of TR, which stands for training. And so down here, you will get a preview of what the file name is going to be for the DGN that we're creating. Our county is going to be Volusia down here. And when you select the county, it automatically selects the coordinate system here. This action area down here is essentially similar to a microstation key-in. If you wanted to create a file while also setting the plot scale or something like that, you could do that here. Create a file and open it up. So it's now opening the file that we just created in the background here, but this create file dialog box stays open. So if you wanted to create another DGN, you could do that. As you can see here, the file sequence has already gone to O2 automatically in case you wanted to create a couple new files at the same time. We only need to create one, so we are going to go ahead and close out of the dialog box. And now we have our clean, empty DGN file to start work on. Moving forward, the exercises for each chapter are independent of one another and can be used without having to create the exercise from the previous module. To accommodate this, we have provided a data set that can be downloaded from the FDOT website and can be used as a starting point for all of the exercises going forward. You'll find the link to the data set location in the training manual in Chapter 1. I'll just navigate to the site now. So this is the FDOT site within the Open Bridge Modeler training. This is where you'll find the training guide in PDF form, as well as at the bottom we have the data set. So you can go ahead and click to download the data set, and it'll download as a zip file. And then you'll have to unzip that to your hard drive. I already have the files unzipped here in this folder. So what you want to do is copy all of these files from the data set here, and you'll want to paste them into the new work set that we created within the structures folder. So we want to paste them all here in this folder. And once these are all pasted, you should be able to begin each exercise as it's labeled here with these DGNs, and you'll be able to start at the same starting point that we are in the videos. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office series for FDOT Connect. This was exercise 3.1 for the OBM Intro to Model-Centric Design Guide. In the next video, we'll continue exploring the FDOT Connect OBM workspace and features, which is also located in Chapter 3 of the training manual.